In this week's Fixture Friday, we're going to take a look at one of our customers' pallets that got him 20 parts per pallet and plenty of walkaway time. So this week's Fixture Friday came from Jason Esher with E3 Manufacturing in Littleton, Colorado. Jason has a machine shop and he purchased a few of our pallets, our 10 by 16 pallets, to use with our Pro Pallet system. So let's take a look. Now here's the first photo he sent me. Over here is the pallet. Now notice he's got twin pallets going on here. That's great because while one pallet is being machined, he's unloading and loading the second pallet outside of the machine. So taking a look at this, this is before or ready to go stage, and this is what it looks like when it is done with the cycle. Let me zoom in here and show you the configuration that Jason is using. So in the strip form, he's getting 5 parts per raw stock, and he's holding it with 3 different types of clamps. The first one is these talon grips. Talon grips are double-sided and they have a knife style edge, so it gives a really aggressive hold, which is perfect for first off work. Then he uses the classic pit bull clamp on both sides. So having pit bull clamps on both sides of the talon grip gives good even holding pressure on your part. For the second operation, he uses machinable uniforce clamps. Now the uniforce clamps are nice because you can turn them into what's essentially soft jaws. So zooming in really tight here, you can see that he's cut it to match the profile of his part. Now on the pallet side, he's put it into a pocket, and again, that pocket has a sort of soft jaw type of look too. So the part is always being pushed up against a large, broad surface. And from what he told me, it's holding just great. Let me zoom out and we'll take a look at the before pallet. So over here, it's nice. You can see that he's just setting the raw material right on the top of the pallet, which he's face milled. So he's got a really consistent Z height to start from. Then he flips it over and you can't see it here, maybe peeking in over here, but again, that profile is held with the uniforce clamps, and then he's face milling it and then adding all the chamfer features that you see. Kind of like the design features of these little like finger grips, if you will, all the way around. So overall, really good set of pallets. Okay, so here we are taking a look at the second photo. Now, what I love that Jason did here is he used our 10 by 16 inch pallets. And that's great because he has a Haas Super Mini Mill, or maybe a Mini Mill 2, which has, if I remember correctly, 20 inches of travel in the X and 16 inches of travel in the Y. So by using our largest pallet, he's maximizing the machining work area and he's maximizing essentially the number of parts he puts on the pallet. Okay, and in this third photo, this is the second set of pallets for a very similar looking part. Now for the first operation, you can see he used the same method here of using the talon grips in the middle and then the pit bull clamps on each end. In this, he's getting 10 op 1 parts and then 10 op 2 parts, which is fantastic. Now the nice thing that Jason did here was he used the cut to length uniforce style clamps. So this is all one piece of material that expands out. Again, it's a kind of like a soft jaw approach. And then your center clamping thing that actually pushes out and clamps on the parts. What I love about this is the little amount of work Jason is actually doing to clamp a lot of parts. So he's tightening 1, 2, 3, 4 screws to clamp on 10 parts in the second op, and only 4 screws, again, to clamp on 10 parts in the first op. That's some incredible efficiency of motion right there. So let me highlight the 3 things that stand out to me in his set of pallets. Number 1, the efficiency of movement. Going back to his first pallet, Because Jason is unloading and loading the pallets outside of the machine, he's actually minimized the amount of work he actually has to do to get these parts out and then back in, ready to go. In total, he is tightening down 11 clamps to get 20 parts, which is fantastic. That's what you want to do. In the second set of pallets, like I mentioned, he's really minimized the amount of work he has to do to have that much clamping efficiency. Now, the second thing is the offline part loading. That is absolutely the right approach with palletized work holding. You want to minimize spindle downtime. When the spindle is not turning, profit is not flowing. So if you can do the slow part of unloading and loading parts outside of the machine, the pallet swaps are about 20 seconds. That also frees up the operator, in this case, Jason or his employee, to go run other machines or do other things like inspection or deburring or just taking a break. That's the nice thing that I like about these. And finally, taking a look at that second photo is the use of his work envelope. If you've got a machine that can hold our large pallets, definitely do it. The only time you want to go smaller is if the weight of the fixture is a concern. Now, out of the box, unmachined, our 10-inch by 16-inch pallets are 24 pounds. So if you have lots of pockets and you have light aluminum parts, the weight's not really gonna be an issue. Also, the mini mill here is a relatively small machine, so leaning in isn't that big of an issue. If you're loading something like a VF5 or above, or a bigger Doosan mill or something like that, you don't wanna be leaning in with that much weight. But Jason definitely used the work envelope to perfection in this. So overall, really great set of pallets. Well done, Jason. If you want more inspiration, search the hashtag PiersonFixtureFriday on Instagram. And if you have a set of fixtures that you want to share with us, also add that fixture, even if you posted it months ago. And if it stands out to us, we might ask to use your fixture in an upcoming Fixture Friday. So until then, go innovate your production.